Want to self-host N8N on your Linux VPS for workflow automation? In this video, I'll show you how to install N8N using Docker on Ubuntu/Debian, set up your domain, and configure SSL with Nginx, step by step. First, make sure Docker is already installed on your Ubuntu/Debian server. If it's not installed yet, feel free to check out the video linked in the description below for a full installation guide. Besides Docker, make sure Portainer is also up and running on your server. It will help us manage containers visually and more easily. Next, check and get the public IP address of your VPS, so we can use it during the configuration steps coming up. After running the command, you'll see your VPS public IP address displayed on the screen. Make sure to copy that IP address and save it. Alright, everything is ready now. Let's create a folder named N8N to store the configuration files and persistent data for N8N. Inside the N8N folder, we're going to create two essential files to configure and run N8N using Docker env stores environment variables like username, password, time zone, etc. Launch a Docker Compose YML defines the container setup and required services. Before we open the env file, let me quickly explain why this file is important. The env file is used to store environment variables, allowing you to manage configurations in a cleaner and more secure way, instead of hard-coding sensitive data like passwords or ports directly in the Docker Compose YML file. Plus, it makes updating your config easier. Later on, you only need to edit one file. Now let's open the env file and add the necessary environment variables for N8N to run properly. In the line that says N8N host, paste the public IP address of your VPS that we got in the previous step. In the code section below the video, I've added comments explaining each line in the config file. So if you'd like to understand the details of each setting, feel free to check it out down there. Once you've added all the necessary content to the env file, go ahead and save and exit the file, so we can move on to the next step. Next, let's open the Docker Compose YML file to add the configuration for running N8N with Docker. This file will define the services, ports, networks, and how N8N connects to your data and environment variables. These are environment variables pulled from the env file we created earlier. This separation makes your configuration cleaner and allows you to easily update values without touching the compose file directly. Once you've added all the necessary content, save and exit the editor to move on to the next step. Now we'll proceed to launch N8N using Docker Compose. This command will pull the N8N image, create the container, and run it in the background based on your configuration. Depending on your internet speed, the first time setup might take a few seconds to a couple of minutes. After the installation is complete, you'll see an output like this. This means N8N is now up and running in the background on your server. You can also check the details of the N8N container, including its port and status. You'll see detailed information about the containers, including N8N and Postgres. However, if you're looking at the Docker PS output, it might look a bit cluttered and hard to follow. Instead, you can use Portainer to manage and inspect your containers in a more visual way. Here, you'll find all container-related information displayed much more clearly and easier to follow than using the command line. With Portainer, you can also easily restart, pause, or stop containers with just a few clicks. Alright, now let's move on to the next step, opening firewall port 5678, so you can access N8N from outside your server. The firewall on your server is currently inactive. You can skip this step and move on to the next one. Alright, everything is ready. Now let's try accessing N8N in your browser. Open your browser and enter the following address. On your first visit, you'll need to enter your email and password to create the admin account for N8N. Once you've logged in successfully, you'll be redirected to the main N8N dashboard. From here, you can start building your own automation workflows. However, to ensure better security and to make access easier, especially when integrating authentication with platforms like Google, you'll need to connect a custom domain and configure an SSL certificate for your N8N server. To do that, you'll need a domain or subdomain that is already pointed to your VPS's public IP address. Once your domain is successfully pointed, you can also access N8N via your domain, instead of using the IP address. However, at this point, the connection is not yet secured with SSL, so your browser might display a not secure warning. We'll fix that next by setting up SSL using certbot. Before setting up SSL, we need to update a few important parameters in the ENV file. First, replace the server IP address with your domain name. Next, change the protocol from HTTP to HTTPS. Next, uncomment the webhook line and enter your domain name. Next, change the value from false to true. Once you're done editing, save and exit the ENV file. Next, open the Docker Compose YML configuration file. Uncomment the webhook line. Then save and exit the Docker Compose YML file. Now we'll install Nginx and Certbot to set up a reverse proxy and enable SSL for N8N. Now we'll create an Nginx configuration file to set up a reverse proxy for N8N and prepare for SSL setup. Then, add the following content to the configuration file you just created. Replace your domain in the server name section with your actual domain or subdomain. Then, save and close the configuration file. Next, create a symbolic link to enable this configuration. Now check the Nginx configuration to ensure there are no syntax errors. If everything is correct, you should see the message. Now, restart Nginx to apply the changes you just made. Next, if you're using a firewall, make sure that ports 80 and 443 are allowed. If you haven't opened ports 80 and 443 yet, add them using the following commands. Now we'll use certbot to issue an SSL certificate for your domain, enabling secure HTTPS connections for N8N. If you see a message like this, that means you've successfully issued the SSL certificate for your domain. Now, access N8N again using the domain name you've configured. If everything is set up correctly, you'll see that the connection is now secured with HTTPS. And that's it. You've successfully installed N8N on a Linux VPS using Docker, configured your domain, and secured the connection with SSL via Nginx. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and drop a comment below if you have any questions.